Greetings, Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020 friends, and welcome to Patriot Six. This tutorial is part of a series of single subject videos designed for quick reference to supplement my long form tutorials. If you're new to using SDK or need a refresher on the tools, I recommend a tutorial on getting started and learning the tools. This tutorial will give you all the basics from obtaining SDK and setting up scenery folders to operating the developer camera and building polygons. You can find a link to this tutorial in the description below. Please click on the Show More button and the tutorial will be the first YouTube link you see. And now on to the quick reference guide. Quick Reference Guide Overview. In this quick reference guide, I'm going to start an airport project, and in this airport project, I'm going to override an existing airport. When creating an airport, whether it be overriding an existing airport or building a fictional airport, building the project is a different method than I use for building regular scenery projects. If you have reservations or concerns about overriding an airfield, then let me tell you that you can do no harm. All the work that you do will be in a scenery folder. And for the scenery folder to even work or make a difference, it has to be in your community folder or any other designated folder you may use for scenery in Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020. So in essence, by simply removing the folder from your community folder or deleting the folder, everything goes back to normal. So you can do no harm. So do not worry. You can do this and it will work. The first step is you obviously need SDK installed. To do this work or any scenery, you're going to need SDK installed. If you haven't installed SDK yet, you will need to do that. In the tutorial I mentioned at the beginning of this video, we'll walk you through the steps that you need to install SDK on your system. Developer's Mode. So let's go into developer mode first, and I will do that by going to Options, General Options, Developers, On, Apply and Save. Zone in and observe project site. I have selected KCKV Outlaw Airport in Clarksville, Tennessee. And I selected this airport because it needs a lot of work. And there will be multiple quick reference guides to follow this one. And we will walk through all of the steps to make this airfield look better. There is a lot missing from this airfield and it can be improved significantly. And by the time we complete the quick reference guides, this airport will be much better. So I want to pick a location to park. And now I'm going to change the time of day to midday. And I'm going to turn the live weather off. And now I'm going to zone into the airfield. Okay, we're now zoned into the airport. So I'm going to go ahead and hit ready to fly. And as you can see, the developer menu is up here above. And I'm going to Options. And I'm going to pause the simulator. And I'm pausing the simulator just so the time of day stays the same. Next, I'm going up to Camera. and I'm going to hop in the developer camera. And as we look over the airfield, you can see it needs a lot of work. Open the project editing tools. So the next step, I'm going up to the developer menu. I'm going to editors, and I'm going to open the project editor. And the project editor comes up along with the inspector. We need both. We need the inspector up, so if the inspector doesn't come up for you, you can drop down on the project editor, tick on view, and tick on inspector. And you can toggle the inspector just by ticking on the view. Create the scenery folder. And the next step is to go to the project editor, tick on project, tick on new project, and let's expand this window a bit. And the very first thing you want to do is select the folder in which you want your project to be saved. We go up to the project folder and tick on it. Now, if you followed my tutorials, you know that I use a folder on the desktop called Working Scenery Folder. So I'm going to navigate to the Working Scenery Folder. And here is the Working Scenery Folder, and it shows up here. So I'm going to select this folder for the project. And now for the project name, I'm going to give it the ICAO code of the airport, KC KV. You can enter the default creator name in this box, and you'll notice this has a space and this does not. This creator name will show up for the content manager, and this creator name will be part of the package. That is the difference in the two. Now I'm going to create new project. I'm going to tick on package and then tick next. And I'm going to select airport. And again, I'm going to give it the same display title. And then I'm going to tick next. And you notice that we have two options, to overwrite an existing airport or to create a new airport anywhere. We're going to stick with override because we're overwriting an airport. And since we're overwriting the airport, all the pertinent information is here in terms of the latitude, the longitude, and the altitude. So now I'm going to create airport. You'll notice that information populated into the inspector, as well as a package name down here in the project editor. At this time, I'm going to go ahead and place my personal thumbnail in here. This is also a subject I cover in the tutorial I mentioned earlier. I'm going to tick on this, and it navigated to the Working Scenery folder. If it had not, I would have manually navigated to this folder. I'm going to select the Patriot 6 thumbnail and tick open. And now, with all the information in the inspector as I want it, I'm going to build the package. This is absolutely vital that you build the initial package. Without building the package, you cannot continue forward and do any work and keep the work. So on the inspector, I'm going to build package. And this dialog box always pops up saying that information has changed that has already been saved. So it's safe to tick yes. and the package has now been completed. And if we look up here at the top, we see 96 potential errors, but we have zero, so we're good to go. And we can exit out of the console. Open the scenery editing tools. And now at this time, I'm going to drop down on the scenery BGL, select it, and up on the inspector, I'm going to load in editor. I'm going to move the material folder over. So as the scenery is loading in, here's what we see. We see an objects window, we see a gizmo, and we see the scenery editor. If you do not have the objects and the gizmo down on the scenery editor, you can go to View, and you can tick on Objects, and you can tick on Gizmo. And now we will wait while the assets from my scenery library load in. Now all of the objects from the scenery library have loaded in, and I want to make sure down in the scenery editor I'm ticked on Outlaw. And now up on the scenery editor I'm going to View and Properties. And the properties window is here. And you can put it wherever you want, but I like to keep it here over the inspector. It gives me more room on the screen to see what I'm working on. And this is where we're going to stop this quick guide. Preview the next quick reference guides. We will pick up and continue on, and when we pick up and continue on, we will be working on the delete command. If I tick on the delete command, and let's move this out where we can see it and make this larger. These are all of the different aspects of the airport that we can delete and rebuild. And that's where we will pick up in the next quick reference guide. It will work our way through this airport and completely rebuild it. Save and close all tools. We haven't added any scenery or anything that needs to be saved, but it doesn't hurt to continually save the scenery down here on the scenery editor. And I'll tick Save Scenery just out of an abundance of caution. And now I'm going to close the editors down. Wrap up. And we will pick up again with the next quick reference guide and slowly work our way through this airport and rebuild it. So if you're not a subscriber, you probably want to reach down there and click that subscribe. So when each of the new reference guides comes out, you will know it and we can work through this together and rebuild an airfield. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and I hope these quick reference guides are popular. The idea is to be able to quickly go through the steps and also have it archived if someone needs to come back and refresh their memory. And with that, I'm going to say goodbye. I will see you in the next one. This is Patriot Six. Please subscribe and thank you for watching.